everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is gonna be my second video and it's my evening skincare routine. I did my morning skincare routine for my first video, so if you haven't seen that yet, I'll link it down below. You'll see me using the same products in my evening skincare routine as my morning skincare routine, but I do incorporate whatever I don't use in the morning at night. So if you'd like to see my evening skincare routine, please keep watching. Normally, I cleanse my face in the shower, but I'll just show you for today how I do that. Every Wednesday, I do a mask and I exfoliate with a scrub. So normally I do that in a shower along with my cleansing, but I'll show you how I do those in my bathroom right now. For my scrub, I use the Acure Brightening Facial Scrub. Using this well over 3 years, I believe this is my second tube. So what I do is start on my cheeks, and just like I mentioned in my morning skincare routine, I time for how long I spend on each quadrant of my face. So for my cheeks, I do 10 seconds, because each cheek you're supposed to spend 10 seconds on it with cleansing, so I kind of do the same thing with my exfoliation. And then I do 20 on my chin and nose. And I tend to get a lot of blackheads or those sebaceous filaments on my nose, and a lot of whiteheads right in the crevices of my nose. Underneath too, actually, like right here underneath my nostrils. A little bit on my cheeks, on the side of my nose, and my chin. Kind of like everywhere on my T-zone, basically. So they get so oily in those areas. And then I do 20 on my forehead. So you want to be really gentle when you exfoliate. All you have to do is use the pads of your fingers and just gently move the product around. You don't have to like really scrub into your skin. You'll pretty much break the skin like that. And your skin's not going to be happy after that. So I just take it down to my neck. And any scrub that I use, I actually use it on my chest too, but because I'm not in my shower, I won't do it. Now that that's done, I'm going to rinse it off. So I don't know if you can see that, but those grains are pretty big. Kind of like sand. It's fun. Now that I've finished exfoliating, I'm going to go in with my cleanser. So I also mentioned in my morning skincare routine that I use a cleansing device. I believe this is called a Foreo Luna 2. I don't think it's a mini. Although actually looking at it, I think it's a mini. I'll just link everything down below. So it's a cleansing device and it's not like the Clarisonic where you buy replacement brush heads. This is all made of silicone, so more hygienic. It won't ever mildew, and it's actually pretty indestructible. I've dropped this more times than I can count. But on the side, it has softer bristles here, and then on the back, it has rougher ones. And this is to get into the sides of your nose here, anywhere you pretty much have like blackheads and whiteheads. And then for my cleanser, I've been using the Whamisa by Glow Recipe Green Tea Foaming Cleansing Gel. And the reason I use two different ones in the morning and at night is just because I ordered from Glow Recipe's site and there was a huge problem with their shipping. And to compensate for all the problems there were, they gave me a full size of this cleanser. I've actually been really enjoying it. The smell is... the smell is actually pleasant. With my Foreo and the cleanser is I just put a tiny dot on it. Then I start on a cheek. So it basically just moves around your cleanser. And if you're wondering why I don't use a Clarisonic, I find this to be gentler. I think over time my face just got really sensitive to using the Clarisonic brushes. And I really like the 4AL2 because it's more, well, you save more money because you don't have to buy the replacement brushes. So if you can hear that, it times your whole cleansing session. So it's 10 seconds on each cheek and 20 seconds on your T-zone. And besides, this thing is so cute. It's like totally handheld. And it's actually gentle enough to use around my eyes. And you know what the greatest thing about this is? One charge lasts 6 months, so it's awesome. So again, like in my morning skincare routine, I'm just bringing around my eyes, under my eyes, and my neck. And it's really easy to clean. I have small bottles of Dr. Bronner's soap laying around my house, and it's my favorite multi-purpose soap. I was actually using this as a cleanser for years, but it is super powerful, so it can be a little drying, so I stopped doing that. But all I do is just put a little bit on the device, and then I just lather it up, and then just rinse it. Now that I've gone in with my exfoliator and my cleanser, I'm going to go in with a mask. This is my Shea Moisture Hydrating Mud Mask. I really, really like this mask. It kind of threw me off a little bit when it said hydrating mud mask because, you know, how could a mud mask be hydrating? But it's formulated for dry skin and it has shea butter in it. So getting the benefits of purging your pores of all that gunk while also moisturizing it at the same time. So first, just like I do before every mask that I apply, I put a little bit of coconut oil on my eyes, since I obviously am not going to put that mask on my eyes. Going with the mask. So it's very thick, but when you touch it, it feels like shea butter. I do feel a tingle on my face every single time I put this mask on. It's kind of like a stinging kind of tingle, but it's nothing like my face is on fire. I don't know what it is about me, but even when a skincare product starts kind of burning a little bit, I kind of just am like, oh, that's just what it's supposed to do. And I just like leave it anyway. My skin kind of gets used to things really easily, so my neck as usual. I never ever neglect my neck. It's going with a thin layer of masks so that the mask sits evenly on my skin and actually does work, because if you put a layer of mask on that's way too thick, then it'll take forever to dry and it won't do anything. I'm gonna leave this on my skin for 10 minutes. Hey guys, took my mask off and my face feels really, really soft. Sorry for the change of venue. I don't know if you could tell from the beginning of this video that, well, I was out of breath and I'm still out of breath for some reason, so I have to sit down. Now that I have my mask off, I'm gonna go into the rest of my skincare routine. Here I have my skincare basket that I carry from my room to my bathroom every morning, but I don't leave all my skincare products in there. Some of these I actually leave in the bathroom. But for the most part, I leave my skincare products in my room because in the bathroom, it gets really, really steamy and it messes with your skincare products. So I would recommend not to put any of your skincare products in your medicine cabinet or lined up on your counter. So don't do that. So for toner, I use the First Aid Beauty Facial Radiance Pads. This has lactic acid and AHA in there, and I use this every night as my toner instead of a traditional toner because it really balances my skin out since I have combination dry skin. But my T-zone gets super oily, and I found that this makes my skin really, really soft and gets rid of any pimples that I have. And of course, because I'm cheap, they actually come in rounds, but I cut them in half and then I cut them in half again. It probably was a really bad idea for me to cut them into quarters, because I actually use this on my chest too. So the reason I do this though is because they're so saturated, and I feel like if you use a whole round, it's just too much. So a half of a round is enough for your face, your neck, and your chest. I guess I'm really that cheap. So I'm just going to do this all over my face. Always my neck. And see, that's what happens when the stupid thing is too small, ends up dropping. And so I go down to my neck, my chest. I should not have done that because I put on some pimple stuff on my chest. Okay, well, I just wiped it away. Cool. So now I go in with my do-it-yourself hydrating spray that I featured in my morning skincare routine. I'm gonna shake it. I'm gonna go ham. Basically, you haven't sprayed enough if it doesn't go up your nose. Now that I have my hydrating spray on, I'm going in with my Whamisa Organic Flowers Eye Essence, same eye product that I use in my morning skincare routine. Now I'll go in with my aloe vera gel. And this is an aloe vera gel that I got from Amazon Instant Natural. I wanted to try their aloe vera because I use their rosehip seed oil, and I really like this brand. It's all natural. I use this to calm down any redness I have in my skin, and that's mainly from pimples and rashes. And until it's completely absorbed. I mean, even if it's slightly tacky, it's okay. For that, I go in with my Whamisa Organic Flowers Toner Deep Rich. This is an essence, and if you don't know what an essence is, it's a liquidy, it's a concentrated version of a toner. And you can use this in place of your toner, but I actually like to use this in conjunction with my toner. And this is purely for hydration. And it has naturally fermented ingredients in here, so we're talking about like super antioxidants and anti-aging properties. Just going to take a little bit in my palm. Probably like a nickel size, I would say. Should probably put my basket on the floor. I keep knocking into it. So I just spread it all over my face. Down my neck. Chest, and then I pat. So at this point, you can give yourself like a tiny little massage here. I mean, just like tapping your face is already considered a massage. Just getting the circulation going. And yes, I did drink water before this, so any massage that I do during this routine will be much more effective. Freaking essence smells so freaking good. It smells so floral. It's so calming. I would count that as an aromatherapy product. Oh, smells so good. Makes my skin so glowy and plump. My essence is still slightly tacky, but pretty much absorbed. I'm gonna go in with my vitamin C serum. Use the Osea Malibu Brightening Serum, and it has vitamin C and ferulic acid in there, and the ferulic acid makes the vitamin C more effective. So every time I buy a vitamin C serum, I have to make sure that it has ferulic acid in there. So I just take a tiny pump of it. It's serum, so it's super concentrated. It's an anti-aging product because it fights sun damage and promotes collagen production, which we lose over time in our skin as we grow older. And it also brightens my skin. This vitamin C serum, because it's so silky. Not like dimethicone silky, but it's a very soft serum. Now that I have my serum on, I go in with my tea tree oil. Anywhere I have a rash or a pimple, I put my tea tree oil on it. Now that I have tea tree oil on my face, I go in with my oil mix, jojoba oil, rosehip seed oil. This is from my morning skincare routine too. But what I do differently at night with my oil mix is I take my LJH Vitapropolis Ampoule. I love the serum so much. I know it's like super tiny and it actually is pretty expensive. I believe it's like $38 or something like that on Glow Recipe's site. But I really, really like this serum. It not only brightened my skin, but it hydrates the heck out of it. And one drop goes a really long way. So I just take a little bit and I put it in my palm. I also talked about this product on my blog post if you want more information on it and why I love it so much. So also something different is I take this gross bottle of licorice root extract, and what this does is it lightens and fades scars over time. It's so powerful that they put it in a lot of skincare products for that purpose. I know it's kind of weird to be putting something like this in my skincare routine, but I would count myself as like half natural, like green beauty, half conventional-ish. I mean, I wouldn't really say like conventional in the sense of like I don't care what they put in it, but at the same time, like, I like science and I like natural, so you just have to pick and choose like what products work for you. So my oil's all over my face. This is the time when I do my facial massage at night. I'll do a separate video on my facial massages, so watch out for those. My evening massage is more geared towards firming the skin and lifting it. My last step is to go in with my moisturizer, and this is my Tatcha Indigo Soothing Triple Recovery Cream. I love Tatcha products. This is my first and only Tatcha product because their products are super expensive, but I love Japanese skincare so much. And the reason I got this was because I was looking for a soothing moisturizer since I have eczema patches on my skin. And I feel like I've had this moisturizer for over a year and a half. A little goes such a long way because this is a really thick moisturizer. So I just use my little applicator here, my little spatula that I took from another moisturizer that I stopped using, and I just go in there. Probably take about this much. I have a big face, so sometimes I go in with more. It depends, because if I don't have enough from my neck and my chest, I'll go in with just a little bit more. I dot the moisturizer on my face and I just massage it in. So in my skincare routines, I go in the order of thinnest consistency to the thickest. I even read that you're supposed to put oil on after your moisturizer, but for me, because I like to use my oils for my facial massage, I like to use that before my moisturizer. And because I'm using such a thick moisturizer too, that I feel like if I put my oils on after that, they won't penetrate as effectively. And now I'm done with my evening skincare routine. Just a side note, if I have any pimples that I popped, I would use my Clean and Clear Advantage Mark treatment, and it has salicylic acid in it. I recently read a blog post that you're only supposed to use drying acne treatments on pimples that have just been popped. So if you put your pimple treatment on a pimple that is just coming up and it doesn't have a whitehead yet, then you're just creating a barrier on it and it won't have the chance to actually become a head. I hardly use this anymore because I've been trying to keep my grubby fingers off my face. I mean, even though I use my pimple extractor, I really try not to, and I think that it's doing my skin way better than popping the heck out of my face. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you haven't seen my first video yet, I'll link it down below, and I probably will have it on the end screen somewhere. I'll have everything linked down below that I mentioned in this video. Follow me on Instagram, Pinterest, subscribe to my blog to see more from me. I do a lot of tips and I feel like they're really helpful. So if you would like to see that, go to my blog and subscribe. Leave me your email on there, or you can even follow me on Bloglubbin if you have that. And I hope you have a wonderful day or night wherever you are in the world, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!